Today we'll discuss about JEE Mains 2016 paper, Physics. Students, let us solve the next question, the question number 2. The question number 2 says, a particle of mass m is moving along the side of a square of side A. So this is a square whose side is A, and the particle is moving like this, A to B, B to C, C to D, D to A, with uniform speed. Uniform speed means constant speed. So speed is constant, V. In XY plane, this is XY plane as shown in the figure. Which of the following statement is false? So first thing you have to note that you have to pick the false statement for angular momentum about the origin. If this is origin, then you have to find the angular momentum about O. So because angular momentum is vector, you have to notice two things. First, its magnitude, then its direction. Both things you have to notice. So if your answer is not matching, then that answer is false. So now we have to solve it. So first of all, as I read out the options, angular momentum is this when the particle is moving from A to B. So you have to check from A to B what is the angular momentum. Similarly, C to D, similarly B to C, similarly D to A. That means you have to find the angular momentum from each of its sides when the particle is moving. So then you see which one is not correct, that is false. So I will draw a line or a that this is the situation, and I will consider this as the origin. Now all sides are A, the particle is moving like that. The sense of motion is also important, because the angular momentum, it's vector quantity. If this is O, this is my x-axis and this is my y-axis. Now I'll start from here. This point is called A, this is B, this is C and D. Now the speed of the particle, I will represent the particle here of mass m, which is moving in this direction at the velocity v, and that mv will continue for this side also, m into v, for this side also, m into v, for this side also, m into v. This is a momentum, linear momentum, but we are interested in angular momentum. Now if you look here, angular momentum about O. Let us see the angular momentum about O. Now first of all, we will check this from A to B. A to B. As the particles move like that, this angle is given 45 degree, this angle is given 45 degree, and this distance is given r vector. This is called r vector. This is r vector. Okay, now this is r vector and this is mv. We know that the general expression for angular momentum is r cross p. This is the angular momentum about the point you are concerned. Suppose point is O, then r cross p. R cross p, if you solve this, and we'll find the magnitude first and see the direction is like that, because r is in this direction, r is in this direction, and mv is in this direction, so it is downward. So it is minus k cap direction. So in magnitude, I will write it is rp sine theta. And we must know that this r sine theta, r, this is r, I have written smaller, but it's okay, write capital R. This r and sine theta together, this r sine theta together gives you r perpendicular. That is a perpendicular distance. Yeah, how to get that perpendicular distance? You have to first extend the momentum line. This is the momentum line. In this momentum line, you extend forward or backward, whatever is required. and you drop a perpendicular from the point about which you want to find the angular momentum. So I want to find the angular momentum about this point. So therefore, I will drop a perpendicular from this point onto the extended line of momentum. So that distance obviously will be, that perpendicular distance will be obviously this. This is the, I dropped perpendicular from this, and this is the foot of the perpendicular, and this is the, this distance is known as R perpendicular. Okay, this distance is known as R perpendicular. So, so I have to just know this distance. Even if the particle is changing position from here to here and here and here, so during its journey from A to B, the angular momentum is not going to change. Because if I want, I want to apply this formula, then when this is here, then when it is here, then this R will change. So for each time, for each point from A to B, there are infinite ways in which R is changing, and differently the angle will also change. So that is a very difficult concept to find for each time, for each position, the R and the angle. But we can solve this logically by this method, that the whether it is here or here or anywhere, this perpendicular distance will remain same. So in this general concept, what happens is, if R increases, theta decreases. R increases, theta will decrease, but then the product of R and sine theta will remain constant. Therefore, this distance is same for all the positions from A to B. Therefore, I will write this P is momentum, that is MB. R perpendicular is this distance. I know this is R. This is 45, so this is 45. If this is R, this is R cos 45. So this is R. So they have used capital R. I will finally write capital R. So R cos 45 is 1 by root 2. So this is the magnitude of the angular momentum when the particle moves from A to B. But this magnitude and what is the direction, you can use cross product. This is your R vector and this is your momentum vector. So R cross P. So this is your R vector and this is our momentum vector in this direction. So therefore, R cross B is into, so it will be into the plane of this paper. So obviously that is z axis, and obviously that is negative z axis. So therefore, this will be direction wise, this k cap, but negative. So this is in terms of the magnitude and as well as direction. So if I check this, then it is mb root r k cap. So this is correct. What I have got, they have also got this. So this is the correct answer. This is not the false statement. So therefore, this cannot be the answer, because we don't have to pick the correct answer. We have to pick the false statement. This is correct. So this is not the answer. Next, we have to go from C to D. So let us solve for this. Okay. Now, to solve this, you must keep this diagram in mind, because I cannot draw this diagram once again. You draw the diagram in your notebook, then you see what I'm doing. First thing that you have to find from C to D, then this is the momentum line. Okay. You have to draw this perpendicular distance on this line from here, because about O, you have to find the angular momentum. So this line, now in this case, this is the perpendicular distance. So this distance is now the perpendicular distance for this case. If this is the perpendicular distance, then we know this side is A, all sides are A. So from here to here it is A, that means from here to here it is A. And here to here, I got now R by root 2. So this is A plus R by root 2 is the total distance. Because from here to here, it is A. And from here to here, that is from here to here, just now I got R by root 2. From here to here, it is R by root 2. So A plus R by root 2 is the total perpendicular distance. And this is MB. So therefore, from C to D, the angular momentum about O equals to M V, in terms of magnitude I'm writing first, M V R perpendicular, and that is A plus R by root 2. the magnitude. And what about the direction? If you look here, then now, so therefore, if you see this, then you get one thing that this vector is like that, and this is the R vector. R vector is like this, and this is like that. So R MB is upward direction. You can see here R is in this direction and P is in this direction. So R is in this direction and P is in this direction. So R cross P will be upward in positive K axis. So therefore I will write this as K cap direction. So this is the in terms of magnitude and this is the in terms of direction. So now if I see the options, then it is MB R by 2 minus A K cap. It should not be minus A, it should be plus A. Okay. Therefore, this option is wrong option and that is the answer. So option 2 is false. Then we have to see further if any other options are true or false. Let us see the other options also. If I see the question now, look this. Now from B to C, let us talk about B to C. If you think of B to C, this is the momentum line equation. This is the momentum line. Now from here, I will draw a perpendicular like this. So this is the foot of the perpendicular. So this distance into MB. This distance is again nothing but this is A. So from here to here it is A. And this distance is R cos 40 by R by root 2. So again it is R by root 2 plus A. So I will write from B to C. From B to C, the angular momentum about O is MB R perpendicular, that is A plus R by root 2. And what about the direction? I can see here this is R and this is, so this is R and this is P. R is in this direction, P is in this direction, R cross P will be upward, so it will be K cap direction. That is how you find the direction in cross product. So this is the answer. Now I will see the option, this answer is correct. B to C, it is like that. So it is the correct answer. So this cannot be the wrong option. Now let us talk about from the particle is moving from D to A. From D to A, let us see what happens during its motion from D to A. D to A means this journey. From D to A, this is the momentum line equation. Now from here, I will draw a perpendicular like this. So this is the perpendicular. So this distance is R by root 2 because this is R by root 2. So I have to multiply MB with R by root 2. And because this is in this direction, and R is in this direction, so R cross P will be downward minus K cap. So it is MB R by 2. So it will be MB, angular momentum about O will be MB R by root 2 into negative K cap direction. That means it is minus MVR K cap divided by root 2. You can replace this small r by capital R that I have not written, but it means the same thing. So this should be the answer. If I see the option, then MVR by root 2 into K cap not negative, is given positive, but the answer should be negative. So therefore, option 4 is wrong. Means false. Here it is wrong in terms of option 4 is wrong in terms of direction. So our final answer should be option 2 is false. And option 4 is also false. So if I see then option 2 and option 4 both are correct. Both are answer to this question. Okay, so what I have done is you have to just think one thing, that you have to find momentum line and draw a perpendicular from the point about which you are going to find the momentum, angular momentum. Suppose I change the question. If I say what is the angular momentum about D, the particle is moving like this, angular momentum about D. Then when it is moving from here to here, then this is the perpendicular distance. So I'll write MB into this distance A. And what is the direction? It is up, K cap. Similarly, from here to here, this is the perpendicular distance. Again, it is A, so it is MB as upward. From here to here, this momentum line is in the same direction as the and the momentum line and the point about which you are finding lying the same line. So angular momentum will be zero. There is no angular momentum in this line. So about this it will be zero, and from here to here again it will be zero, because there is no perpendicular distance you can draw from the point to the line, because the line itself, line of action itself, passes through the point about which you want to find the angular momentum. It is just like the torque. If the force, applied force, the line of action passes through the point of rotation, then the body will not rotate, however may be the magnitude of the force. Okay. So this you have to keep in mind. So this is the answer. Thank you.